from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about the very first endocrine gland, that is the hypothalamus. So firstly, we have taken an overview of all the important endocrine glands and some of the hormones synthesized and secreted by those endocrine glands in our body in the last lecture. So, वहाँ पर हमने बात की थी that hypothalamus is present in the brain and the second most important thing that it can secrete some hormones which can stimulate some other organ. For example, stimulatory hormones such as GnRH will stimulate pituitary and some inhibitory hormones which can inhibit the action of some other gland. So, दो तरीके के hormones यहाँ पर हो सकते हैं. So, the very first thing is the location of each and every gland. After that, the second important thing is what kind of hormones do it make. Okay, what is the different number of hormones and what are the function of those hormones. Okay, and after that, its metabolic role. So, सबसे पहले बात करते हैं about the location. It is present in the diencephalon of the forebrain. In last lecture, we have made a diagram like this. Okay, and the whole body, right? Here, hypothalamus is present something like here and there is the pineal gland, right? So it is present in the diencephalon part, okay? Or we can say the basal part of diencephalon, okay? The base of diencephalon in the forebrain, right? Now, how does it synthesize different hormones? What are the secretory cells? So since hypothalamus is present at the basal part of diencephalon in the brain, it means that it must be having some sort of neurons, right? And when some sort of brain cells are engaged in the function of secretion of making some hormones, they are basically called as neurosecretory cells. Neuro means associated with the brain or neurons. Secretory simply means in this particular case, they are engaged with the process of secretion. So, the hormones will be synthesized by the neurosecretory cells, okay? Several group of neurosecretory cells, and those groups are called as nuclei. So, if someone will ask you what are the different cells in which the hormones are formed, in case of hypothalamus, they are called as nuclei, and they are nothing but they are different group of neurosecretory cells. Since we are talking about hypothalamus in brain, so neurosecretory cells will be present, okay? Now, it regulates a lot of parts, okay, in our body, but it regulates pituitary to the maximum extent. Pituitary is also a very important endocrine gland. In the next video, we will be talking about pituitary gland in detail. So, it used to, you know, control the synthesis and secretion of pituitary hormones. Now, most of the students think that synthesis and secretion are the same words, but no. They are different words and they have very different meanings as well. Synthesis simply means that a hormone is being made at a particular location. Ek jagah pe koi cheez ban rahi hai, that is the synthesis. But if you are sending that particular thing to a destined part, agar aap use uske kaam wali jagah par bhej rahe ho, that is secretion. So synthesis is basically forming a hormone and secretion is sending it to do its function. That is secretion basically. So the synthesis as well as secretion of many pituitary hormones is under the direct control of hypothalamus. So hypothalamus is master at that time, right? Master use bola jata hai. Okay, so there will be a lot of confusion that whether pituitary is called as the master gland or hypothalamus. I'll clear that when we will do the pituitary. Okay, so synthesis and secretion of pituitary hormones is under the direct control of hypothalamus. And how the hypothalamus will control that thing? It will secrete some hormones which are very important to regulate the functions. The very first hormone that we have done is a releasing hormone or stimulatory hormone. Stimulatory, as the name indicates, it is going to stimulate something, right? So stimulate karega kisi bhi cheez ko release hone ke liye. That's why it is called as releasing hormone. For example, GnRH, gonadotropic releasing hormone. Okay, the releasing word is already taken. It means that it will ping the pituitary. Okay, if this is the hypothalamus and this is the pituitary, the hypothalamus will think the pituitary to release the gonadotrophic hormones. Right? So gonadotrophic hormones are released from the pituitary when a signal will come from the hypothalamus, and that signal is called as gonadotrophic releasing hormone. Right? Similarly, the pituitary has some sort of growth factors, okay, and we can say growth hormones. So if the signal from hypothalamus is inhibitory, okay, negative signal, then that negative signal is called as somatostatin. Statin means to make static or to stop, yani ki growth ko stop kar dega, yani ki pituitary growth factors release nahi karega. The pituitary is initially secreting a lot of growth factors which is promoting the growth, but the hypothalamus will give it a signal called somatostatin to tell the pituitary ki bhai ab ruk ja, itni growth kaafi hai, and that is a kind of inhibitory signal because it is stopping the release of growth factors or growth hormones, right? So there can be two different type of categories of hormones which are secreted by hypothalamus. The very first is stimulatory, for example GnRH, and the second one is inhibitory, for example somatostatin, right? So these are very important things. Now how do it control the pituitary? Direct blood se ya fir kuch aur inke beech mein connection hota hai? Let's talk about the connection very well. Let's say this is the hypothalamus, okay? This is the hypothalamus region. Now there are some neurosecretory cells. So let's make some neurosecretory cells over here. Okay, we have already discussed about the structure of neurons. We don't have to do anything in that. Okay, so this is the neurosecretory cells. यहाँ पर neurosecretory cells नहीं है. They will secrete the hormones. Now let's make the pituitary. The pituitary have two different lobes and a medial line. Okay, so this is the pituitary, let's say. Let's say this is the anterior pituitary, this is the posterior pituitary. So this particular nerve will be directly innervating in the posterior pituitary, and the hormones will be released via the nerve endings. So this particular, okay, neurosecretory cells will be forming some sort of hormones. Those hormones will travel through the axon and through the nerve fiber, and they will reach to the nerve endings. The nerve endings will release the hormone to the pituitary. So the neurons is in direct connection with the PP, that is posterior pituitary, okay? So nerve directly posterior pituitary mein ghus jayegi, but that kind of connection is not present between anterior pituitary and the neurosecretory cells. So we need some other mechanism, and that mechanism is called as portal system, right? So there will be some nerves, okay, some bunch of nerves like this, and here also. Okay, so blood vessels का एक bunch होगा यहाँ पर और blood vessel का एक bunch होगा यहाँ पर. That is connecting the neuron with the anterior pituitary. Okay, the neurosecretory cell will be, you know, sending all its जो भी उसने बनाया होगा hormone वगैरह in this stream, and after that that stream will take the secreted products to the anterior pituitary to regulate its function, right? So what is the difference basically? The difference is that posterior pituitary is in direct contact with the hypothalamus with the help of nerve fibers. Okay, वो directly attached होता है because यहाँ से nerve endings जो है direct posterior pituitary में ही अपनी secretions को छोड़ेंगी. But in case of anterior pituitary, such kind of connection is not allowed. So there is a portal system. Portal system means it is specifically joining two different organs. So it is joining hypothalamus to the anterior pituitary. So hypothalamus se nerve nikli, neurosecretory cell nikla, simple bhasha mein. Neurosecretory cell will send its secretion to the bunch of vessels, and after that, that bunch of vessels will take the secretion to the anterior pituitary. We know very well that hormones can travel via blood, so it will be sent it to the anterior pituitary, and depending upon what kind of signal has came from hypothalamus, the functions of pituitary gland will be regulated. For example, यहाँ पे अगर कोई सिग्नल आया that you have to secrete, you know, GnRH, not GnRH, GnRH is the signal, but gonadotropin आपको release करने हैं, so वो release हो जाएंगे, because GnRH is the gonadotropic releasing hormone. It means that gonadotropins are going to be released. This is the name of signal. So this will come from the hypothalamus. Okay. After that, if a signal named somatostatin will come from hypothalamus, the growth factor release will be stopped or inhibited. That is the basics. Okay. So anterior pituitary has the portal system. Posterior pituitary is in direct contact with the hypothalamus with the help of, you know, neurosecretory cells. And there are some important aspects that where it is present, that is very important. On the basal part of diencephalon in the forebrain. Okay. And the neurosecretory cells are called as nuclei. So this is the little bit explanation about hypothalamus. Now the most important gland comes into consideration, that is basically the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is one of the most important glands because it secretes a lot of hormones, maximum number of hormones. So to understand them, we are going to make a trick, and after utilizing that trick, we will be learning each and every function of each and every hormone. So just wait for the next video. Thank you so much for supporting me. If you really like this video, then hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.